मैं थी, तुम थी, कौन था?
बच्चों को संभालना कब आएगा तुम्हें?
ओ स्टॉप इट, आसमान से माँ बनकर नहीं आई हो, तुम्हें भी सीखने में टाइम लगा होगा ना?
लगा, लेकिन तुम जितना नहीं।
बहनों, आज अपने अपने पतियों को उस उल्टा चुड़ैल डायन कुलक्षणी से बचाना है।
As you turn the pages of history, watch movies and Hindi soaps, you'll often find women torturing their kind. They're either pitted against each other or at loggerheads of their own accord. In popular parlance, women are dubbed as women's worst enemies, with stereotypes like "Aurat hi aurat ki sabse badi dushman hai." This, like any other stereotype, is gendered and not unique to one country or culture. Ye har jagah prevalent hai. So we dug deeper to understand the rationale behind why do women pull each other down? The complex answer is patriarchal bargain.
Women are trained to be loyal to men and to be disloyal to other women. If you think about it as power and authority as a scarce good, and it's men that who hold the authority, then women are learning that because they don't hold any power, they don't want to be like each other. So if they don't want to be like each other, who are they going to want to be associated with? They want to be associated with men who have power. Because women are then automatically pitted against each other, and so of course there'll be jealousy. So this is not generic to women's behavior, it's just learned behavior.
The evil mother-in-law suppressing her daughter-in-law is the classic example of patriarchal bargain, a term coined by Turkish author and researcher Deniz Kandioti in the article Bargaining with Patriarchy. Her research tells us in sub-Saharan Africa, the rather independent wives of the same man in polygamy would compete with one another to hold more power as a way to upkeep their households and lands. In classic patriarchy, more prevalent in the Middle East, South Asian and East Asian countries, a woman marrying and moving into a man's house would be subordinate to an older woman, resulting in distrust and power games to survive and gain dignity and agency, both of which were denied or limited through the favor of those in authority, which in the patriarchal system are men. The same conditioning is perpetuated in unsuspecting women over generations. This divides women so they don't speak up or unite for corrective action, paving the way for status quo to continue.
On these behaviors, especially of loyalty to husbands or loyalty to men, there's a very strong moral overlay. So I may want to leave or talk or whatever else I want to do, but you feel like you're not being a good woman. So that's why I say we're feminists with bad habits, because our beliefs are aligned that we should take care of ourselves, we should speak up. And if a man is violating your dignity or your husband or your mother-in-law, whatever else is happening, we have a voice, we have a choice, we're educated, but we still don't do it. And that's the conflict that most of us don't understand and hasn't been written in the way that I explore in the book Chup.
This conditioning impacts the women-to-women dynamics in the workplace too. Women find it hard to trust their female colleagues, especially if the female is their boss. Studies tell us that most of them prefer a male boss. Women need to realize that this mistrust will only make them weaker as a whole. Becoming aware of internalized misogyny and reprogramming our beliefs about ourselves and others is the first step towards breaking free of this conditioning. This does not mean that you must support wrongdoing by a woman, but it does mean that before you accuse another, you check in to make sure that it is not your personal hatred, anger, or resentment that is being projected on another.
Women are challenging it, and I think even on Twitter, there are wonderful movements where women are naming, 10 other women they admire. All this makes a difference, right? Instead of expanding the shame pie, we're expanding the praise by. One of the most powerful ways we can change at work is by creating chup circles, circles of support, where women learn and support each other, especially when they see a woman being put down. Rather than being quiet or rejoicing silently, you speak up, because another time it might be you.
Let's not forget, united we stand, divided we fall.